So today I am near Nelson at the top of Takaka Hill, and the rocks around me are marble, which is a type of hardened limestone. And today is Adventure Geology Day, and I've got a harness and I've got a helmet. So we're going to go down a big hole, and here is my guide, who I'll introduce in a little while. We're getting set to have some sort of adventure and explore down below. So let's see how that goes. That's a long way down, 180 meters deep. Okay, that's encouraging. I guess it'll be a while, but I'll see you at the bottom.
Mm-hmm. Jeez.
So, getting deeper down, there's some people exploring a side passage. Hi there. So I'm sliding down quite gently. I am nearly. Right. I'm down on the ground. Okay, the rope's free. I've got no idea how this shaft has formed. There must have been either a huge collapse of a cavern roof or a big river washed into it. And when I was coming down, I could see that the walls were quite smooth. So I suspect there was a river washing down and maybe partly bits then collapsed later. Now it's obviously, there's no big river up there, so it must have been abandoned, and maybe the water's got diverted in another route and gone underground somewhere else. And I think that's probably what happened. Down where we are right now is a kind of rubble slope. I'll just show you what that looks like. It's just a slope of rubble. You might be able to see the rope going up there in the distance. And the rubble is just like broken rocks that must have fallen down into here, and it goes down, down into the big dark hole over there. So we're at the bottom now, and we're just going to put some of our climbing gear in the bag. I'll keep that one. So most of it's not needed. And Neil, thanks so much for getting me down here safe and sound. I'm very happy to be on my feet on the solid earth. It was pretty terrifying, actually, even though I've been in high rocky places. Neil has suffered me as a teacher at school, and now he's in the lead teaching me how to go through a cave safely. So I'm delighted to be with Neil. He's been down here many times, and that's very reassuring. So I have a little bit of a sense of mystery, because I don't really know what we're in for, but Neil does. So I'm in your capable hands.
So we're going to follow the scree slope down. It leads to an underground cave system that eventually meets a streamway, which comes from who knows where.
So we are now in a really big cavern. It looks like we're near the bottom, is that right?
A little way to go.
A little way to go. Okay. So I can hear the sound of water in the distance. And this at the moment is fairly rubbly underfoot, but it's very easy travel.
Nice and safe, and we don't have to go this way.
Okay. All good. So we're just following a rope down. So we've arrived at the streamway. So this is a small stream. It's not as big as the original one that created the shaft, I'm sure. But nonetheless, this stream is the way forward. But a lot of the time there's this fantastic little ledge of limestone that, that you can walk around and use as a foot ledge to avoid getting too wet. So, amazing flowstone under a waterfall. So here we've got a rock fall that has collapsed a long time ago, and the calcite is starting to precipitate around it, so it's a very old rock fall.
That's a bag I can.
Yeah. See why you need a So we're near the end of a cave, and right at the end we have this beautiful cavern, Starlight Cavern, sparkly and full of stalactites, stalagmites and flowstone, cave coral and straws, all sorts of columns and curtains. It's just magical. I kind of almost don't want it to stop. So I'm going to point the light at Neil for a moment. Yeah, Neil, I just want to say thank you so much for bringing me down this cave.
Yeah, so it's not for the faint-hearted or inexperienced. There is a couple of tricky spots which have sort of had people in, or had people turn back, essentially.
So there's light at the end of the cave here, and there's a pool. Woo-hoo-hoo! Wow, suddenly it's warm. Warm air. Here we are. And there's a little fantail. Or two. Or three. Or four. What a fantastic mission. So that was Harwood's Hole. The deepest shaft in New Zealand, the deepest cave shaft, probably one of the deepest in the Southern Hemisphere, and a spectacular cave system to come through. And now we've come out into the forest, the New Zealand bush, and it's raining. And so finally we're out here at the lower entrance, and we're in the jungle, and we've got a really big hike of 350 meters up a steep track to get back to the beginning and retrieve that rope. So I hope you've enjoyed this video. I've certainly had a whale of a time today, and I look forward to seeing you in the next one.